Hello everyone. Because I liked my reverse flower dip so much in the previous video, I'm going to try it again and to see if it was no beginner's luck, because I liked that flower dip very much. So I'm going to use that reverse flower dip technique again and again. I got inspired by Fiona Art. I will put all the information to her YouTube channel in the description box. And so for the people that are new to my channel and like experience or tutorials about acrylic or resin, consider to subscribe. Click the notification bell and select all, because that way you don't miss anything. So I already started with adding the base coat onto my canvas of 40 centimeters. And again, I'm going to explain to you all how I mixed the paints. So for the background, I used a pouring medium, and I used the pouring medium that also Fiona uses. She uses an acrylic binder and an primer, a kind of primer. So I mixed 80% acrylic binder and 20% of that primer, and that was my pouring medium. And then I've used four parts of the pouring medium and one part paint. And for the background, I added the titanium white and also a little bit of water to make it thinner. And now you can see I'm spreading it over my canvas and with a palette knife. So one more time, 80% acrylic binder and 20% primer. The links to those materials are in the description box. And the primer, it's a kind of medium that you put on your concrete walls to prevent that the wall will suck up your paint, your wall paint. So before you put your wall paint on your concrete wall, you add this primer first. It fixates the wall for sucking up your wall paint. So that's the kind of primer. But I also will put a link to that in the description box. So four parts pouring medium and one part paint. That's for the background. And I used the Winsor & Newton Titanium White. The torch for the air bubbles. Yeah, I also want to see if it was no beginner's luck, because I my first flower dip, I find it amazing, and I got some great cells and lacing. So I want to see if I can do that again. So the first color I'm using is an ultramarine from Amsterdam Acrylics, and I mixed that paint the same. Four parts pouring medium and one part paint, and only a little bit of water, because I wanted the consistency of warm honey, maybe a little bit thicker, but it definitely must not be too thin. That's not good. So I make my lines a little bit wider. So that's why I'm making two rings next to each other. Also in the middle, there you can see. And I again will also add the mixing video of Fiona Art, because she explains it very well how you how she mixes her paints. And I did it the same way as she did, maybe a little less of the primer. But I will add a link to that video also in the description box. So I hope I can create the same beautiful flower shape as I did in the first video I made. But now I'm going to use different colors, of course. Yeah, and this is the pearl white. And this is a mixture of one part pouring medium, one part Vallejo pearl medium, and one part titanium white from Winsor & Newton. And that's the mixture of the pearl white. And I'm adding it next to the ultramarine. And I must say, the first flower dip I did is already drying. And it dries really nice. And it has a nice shine. So it's not matte. So that's great. And maybe I will add a resin layer. If this one also comes out pretty, I will add a resin layer. Because I think that will look nice. And the next color is a turquoise blue from Amsterdam Acrylics. I think those two colors look pretty together, the ultramarine and the turquoise blue. A nice contrast. So next to the pearl white, I'm adding a line of the turquoise blue. And I still have not bought the larger paper napkins that Fiona uses, but I'm going to use a plastic sheet again, and then we will see if that will work again. Maybe this is also possible in resin. I don't know. Maybe I will do an experiment on a smaller MDF board. But then with the resin. But yeah, you can't do put resin in squeeze bottles. So I need to think of how I will do that. Maybe in a silicone cup. I don't know. And the next color is the Winsor & Newton Gold. So next to the turquoise blue, I will add a thin line of gold. And I also want to thank my monthly sponsors again. I want to thank Dolores, Lori and Evelyn, and also Resin Pro and Artisa. Because Lori, Dolores, and Evelyn, yeah, what you do every month, I think, yeah, I'm so grateful. So I have no words for that. And I also want to thank Dolores for the nice birthday card she sent with a special message for me. So, yeah, thank you so much, Dolores. But also Resin Pro and Artisa for sending me those really nice art supplies and resin supplies. So thank you all for supporting me every month. And I'm going to add another color, and that's the Winsor Violet. Very nice dark violet color. And I will add it next to the gold. There you can see it. Yeah, and I'm liking this reverse flower dip technique very much. So I will experiment a little bit more with this technique, maybe on some other surfaces, I don't know yet, but I'm liking it very much. So all the materials I'm using in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box with the links to the website. So also the acrylic binder and the primer and all the paint colors I've used, all the materials. So if you're curious, then you can check out the description box. And if you don't find the primer I've used in the country you're in, yeah, it's an acrylic fixating primer for your concrete wall. Again, some gold. But what I also think is that the Vallejo pearl medium is very important in this technique. I think with that medium you can create those nice lacing and cell effects. So make sure you have that Vallejo pearl medium. Because if you later in the video, if you look at the yeah, it's not the end result, but if you look at what I made and where the lacing and cells are, it's, I think, on a place where the pearl medium is. So I think that's a very important medium to use in this technique. So not only the acrylic primer for the pouring medium, but also the Vallejo pearl medium. So I filled my canvas and now I'm going to add the plastic sheet very carefully onto my canvas. And then we will see what we get. There you can see it. It's not a thin plastic, it's a thicker plastic. And then I press it onto the acrylic paint. There you can see it. To make sure that the plastic touches the acrylic paint all over your canvas, so that you don't have any air bubbles underneath. So I'm not pressing hard, very gently I'm pressing the plastic into the acrylic paint. Yeah, and the exciting part is when you lift the plastic, because it's a large canvas, so the plastic is also large. So I take the corners and I hold my hand with all the corners in the middle, above the middle of the canvas. There you can see it. So now I have the four corners. And now I need to lift it very gently. I think it looks nice. Those colors go very well together. And I already have some nice self-lacing effects. Going to see. Now I'm checking if I move the paint, what it does to the effects. I think it looks nice. And again, I have the same effect, so it was no beginner's luck. So that's great. The torch for the edibles. Yeah, I need to work on the shape a little bit more, but yeah, for the second try, yeah, I'm very proud of myself. Maybe another plastic, I don't know. Need to think about it. But I think it looks great. Let me know what you think of it. And or what you would have done differently. Working on the sides. So at the end of this video, also a close-up, then you can see the cells and the lacing much better than you can see now. So I will also put in the description box how I mix my paints. So if you want to know how I mix them, then you can go to the description box below this video. And there you can find how I mix the paints, the pouring medium and the paints. Again, I'm going to tilt the canvas. And see what kind of effects I'm getting. And also see how much paint is on my canvas. Because I don't want it to crack. And then I'm almost done with this painting. And then I will show you all a close-up. Again, the torch. And then I'm done. And then we can go to the close-up. So this is how the painting looks right after pouring. Yeah, I got some great lacing and cell effects. You can see it already, but I'm showing you later a closer view. But I think it looks great. So again, I want to thank Fiona for making her videos and showing how she mixes her paints and her pouring medium, because I did it the same way, maybe a little bit less primer. But yeah, thank you so much, Fiona, for showing us how you use the reverse flower dip technique. Because that way, yeah, I can also try it out. But I'm so proud of myself. Such nice lacing effects there. You can see it already. The colors go very well together. And the nice gold that shimmers. So in another video, I will show you all the dried results, also from my first flower dip. And yeah, if you like what I'm doing and you haven't subscribed yet, please consider to subscribe. Give me a thumbs up for this video, because that's important for my channel. If you want to know where I buy my materials, you can find it in the description box. also the link to my Facebook, Instagram, influencers, Amazon store, and also my Etsy shop. So a lot of information. I want to thank you all for watching again, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.